Hi everyone and welcome to Motographer Channel. I'm Barry Xia and today I'm going to review the Zontes Scooter 310. Okay, so this is a 2A bike, and thank you Chong Kok for actually letting me try this bike. And let me share a bit more of my thoughts about this bike. So basically, this is not the first scooter I ride. I ride the Aprilia Mojito 125, I ride the Vespa GTS 300, and this. And I can just roughly share my experience with the scooter that I feel the slight difference between all these bikes, and yeah, and here are my thoughts. Let's get to it. So here it is, the Zontes M310 scooter. So basically, how the design is like, I find that the design of the bike in front look like a transformer. Okay, a bit of blowfish style because of this white area, but overall it's like those are modern transformer style kind of thing, and kind of like the air intake over here, you know, so that it will really cool the bike when it's moving. But yeah lah, I mean it's Transformers but then it feels more like the Decepticon than the Autobots, you know, those the villain type. But I like the color. I love the red and the black contrast. So overall the design of the bike is like very modern, very pointy. Okay, and all these already come with it. As you can see, there's already kind of holes for your rack, for your mount. That means your top box or what, you know, straight away you can actually mount it on without like screwing from here to install there. Then overall, yeah, it comes with main stand and side stand, but the bike cannot start when it's on side stand. So only it's on main stand then it can start, or when your side stand is up for safety reason. So this bike, it's also keyless. As you can see, there's only one button for you to start. So the keyless is like the fob, you know, it's like a Fitbit. The first thing I feel is like a Fitbit, so it just look like this, a small little oval one. And they actually will provide you a strap when you buy the bike, the strap that will like put on like a smartwatch kind of thing, so you won't lose your key, yeah, in a way. So I just put it at the small little pocket of my jeans. So overall, the cool part is some few things that I really like about the bike, other than okay, normal scooter, it has a nice comfortable seat, you know, it have a lower back support. And one thing I like about the bike is, other than the space, okay, let's look at the space below. But first, I just press on. Let me on the bike. There you go, you know, the transformer thing. So, let us see the compartments. So, there are a few compartments. Of course, under seat. So, let's press. So, it's all like buttons to press. Same like the Zontes 155. But under the seat, I just press. And there we go. So this is the space. Okay, got my clean towel, this is my tripod, my raincoat, some cloth in case it's wet, you know, kind of thing. Yeah, over here you can actually fit your full face helmet. There's only one, okay, and yeah, this is the one that comes with it. So let me see whether I can show you. Let me take out my gloves. A little tough to show. Okay, over here. So let me see this. There. So for those who have actually used Fitbit before, you'll find this design very familiar. So the first thing I think, wow, this really, you know, it's like Fitbit kind of thing. So yep, here we go. Maybe I'll just put my glove here first. Then the next thing is that the fuel cap location. Okay, because I do sometimes mount bags behind the Vespa. So the problem is that sometimes mounts, you got lots of things on the back of the seat, and when you want to pump petrol, you know, you have to remove that in the petrol kiosk. So that's the thing that I find very leche, very troublesome. But over here, the fuel cap is in front. So to open the fuel cap, just press this button here and you can see. So no matter how much barang you have here, how much luggage you have here, all the way piled up, you still can pump petrol. So I think this is actually a very good move. The thing about this, because of this design, when I get up, yeah, it's a little, it will be a little high, because a scooter is usually low in front. And yeah, Aprilia Mugito, the Vespa GTS, this one is a little higher. So usually I will just back, just like mount my normal sports bike from back. But if from the front, then I have to knee up a little more. That's the only thing. Then there's two compartments here. One on the right, I put my lock. It's quite shallow, okay, so you can access anytime, even when it's locked. So don't put any valuable stuff here. Then another side, it is actually a deeper compartment. Don't know whether you can really see, but there is actually two USB ports over here for you to charge. So you can charge your phone, slot it here while riding. So it comes with a charger already, so might as well. And then I put a handphone mount here, and then it will be locked when the bike is locked. How do I actually lock this scooter? So basically you press and hold, you will hear a sound, and once you turn your handlebar, it's locked already. Okay, so basically with the phone far away, there's no way that anyone can start up the bike. There's no way to even move the bike. The downside about this is that you have to every time on the bike when you're actually shifting, because if you are shifting and your bike is off, then when you're shifting right, you turn all the way left, you auto lock. So you're gonna have some issue maneuvering the scooter. That's the only thing that I find a bit leche, a bit troublesome. But well, security feature, yeah. So if there are cases that you actually left the bike for a while, okay, that you're actually move aside. So let's say, okay, I just move a bit further, then it will actually warn you. It will come out with a beep 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 sound, and it will actually off the whole device. So basically that's about it. Then of course you need to press and hold to lock lah. And one thing I like about this the scooter is, of course, the very basic security feature is this. I did talk about this before in my other Zontes 155 review about why is this so important. It actually protects us on the road because it can't be left signaling and stop. You will get you might get rear-ended. So yeah, and it has adjustable brake levers over here as well. And yeah, that's about it. And one more thing, over here you can see there's a cover. Basically, right, if you notice, there's not much of a mounting point. Of course I can clamp something here, I can clamp something on the window, but then with this, let me take it out, you can access the handlebar straight. So let's say you want a mounting, they will actually they do provide you the mount right over here. So over here, when you remove this, there's like a kind of screw thing. I'm not sure how this is installed. And then after that, you can actually mount your phone here using this, you know, whether your phone or what, with this clip back in. So this is how they will provide you this when you actually purchase the bike. So at least you can access the handlebar, because most of the time, okay, for scooters, all our handphone mounts are usually on the mirror. We actually put mirror, then we put a ball head mount, then after that we start putting the mount up. So with this one, it's actually quite a good feature. They really leave a gap for you already, so you don't need to like, hey, should I, how should I actually mount? Where to mount? There's no screw. Maybe you can use this screw or what. When you use all these screws, you will be blocking the button, so it's kind of like no use. Alright, there's another thing that I actually missed out. It's actually over here, the foot peg. So you can see over here, the foot peg is just flushed into the unit system. So over here, you know, it's just actually, there's no need to put so much pressure to just keep it, and then when you want to pinion, you just pull it out. So the foot peg is actually quite thick, so it actually be more comfortable for your pinion to actually rest your foot. So yeah, this is the part that I actually kind of missed out. So yep, that's about it. Alright, oh wait, I need to take my glove and let's get this baby running. Oh man, the weather is crap again. Oh no. Oh no. Alright, so let me put out, sidestep out, and then just break in and start. So over here, there's a lot of interface. Once it goes set, you will see there's interface, there's clock, there's backlight, unit, language. There's also Bluetooth connection, easy connector that you actually can connect to your phone. But currently it's full Chinese, so it is not that international friendly for now. Okay, so in the interface, there's clock. There's also TPMS, that's the best part. Tire pressure monitoring system. So you can actually set it, you can set it to bar, you can set it to PSI or KPA. So you are able to understand your tire pressure and tire heat. So there is a sensor already built in. How cool is that? Because I actually added TPMS on my Ducati and my Hayabusa, and also even for the Royal Enfield. So yeah. Alright. Now let me... I prefer PSI, so let me exit. Then also there's an interface, you can actually choose simple, casual, you know, sometimes boring, you want to change the interface, go to race, you know, and you can go to street, you know, there's different type. And how, let's see, how does the simple look like? Yeah, this is very simple. Just like that. So yeah, I kind of like street quite a bit. Alright, okay, so this is the eco mode, so you can press eco, sports, you know, but I still prefer the sports mode, even though the fuel consumption is not so much difference, but the sports mode, there's slightly more pickup, more torque, while economical is like, is when you throttle, it will be less sensitive to prevent you from like over throttling kind of thing. But for this bike, I find alright lah. The economy, right, if you throttle hard enough, it also kind of pick up quite well. And then the best part, sometimes, you know, in Singapore, of course, if this is a road trip ahead, okay, the windshield actually help a lot. But when it comes to sudden rain, of course you wear raincoat, all these things, then there's actually a lot of rain coming in. So I actually used this and adjusted my windshield, so it's just a button. So while I'm riding, suddenly sudden rain, I'm not really on my raincoat. Of course, it's like in Singapore, this is how weather is like. So suddenly it just suddenly rain, then after it suddenly gets sunny. Like what you see now, you can actually see some droplets around the bike, and then it drizzled a little bit and now it's sunny. So yeah. So when suddenly I feel the drizzle and suddenly the rain got bigger, I just move up the windshield, it actually helped me to block the raindrops kind of thing. So I find this is quite a cool feature, but of course there's other means for this feature. So it actually blocked the rain quite a bit. And yeah, that's about it. Okay, let's do a bit of riding and see how it feels.
I feel that the sitting position is quite comfortable, and you know, it's the floorboard is nice to step on. The thing is that the front, there's actually two slanted floorboards that you actually can stretch your leg, but for me it's like a bit uncomfortable. It feels still a bit tight for me, but okay lah, I usually will put it down at the floorboard. And the back seat, lower back support is also great. You know, it helps me keep my lower back more comfortable through rides, and especially if you are taking this scooter for a bit of longer ride. One thing about this bike, right, is actually running on 14 inch rims front and back. Okay, I ride the Vespa GTS 300, which is actually 12 inch by 12 inch, and the Aprilia Mojito 125cc, which is 12 inch in front and 10 inch behind. So for the 10 inch behind, it's like finding a needle in a haystack. You know, you are unable to really find that type of rim. So with these 14 inch rims front and back, it's much more easier to find. That's what I feel. The stock tires come with CST tires. They are fully China made, but I'm really surprised because the China, even though it's China made, it is actually very grippy. I mean, it's quite grippy even in wet roads, because I did ride this in the rain, especially in this month there's a sudden rain downpour in between. So when I ride through the rain, I can really feel the grip. I don't feel much of sliding at the rear, or when I actually brake a little more, it still grips well. So I'm quite amazed. And it is CST tires, that's the brand of it. And this bike is like fairly easy to U-turn, because this is, even though it's a two-way bike, the frame is a little shorter. It is not as long as like X-Max. So when you do a U-turn, it's much more agile, it's much more easier to just clear the corner. That's what I felt about this scooter. Okay, because I also feel it is actually quite hard for longer frame to actually do U-turns, especially when I try with my Hayabusa, with my Honda Phantom. You tend to have to lean a little more to clear because of the long frame. That's all. It's just the characteristic in the design of the bike. So yeah, this frame is short and it's easy to maneuver. I can say it's really agile and it's easy to handle. It's very easy to handle. And even though I'm at tight places, I can easily maneuver in tight spaces, especially in a car park, which I actually face at Raffles City. The motorcycle parking lots are really cramped up, so I managed to actually maneuver everything inside that tight lot. And oh my god, over here there is actually a little droplets, and it's time for me to put out my windshield. Okay, basically the windshield is just like protecting me from the droplets only lah, the water droplets. It actually lessened down a lot. Okay, it doesn't block fully, but it lessened down a lot. It's actually quite high, as you can see, but oh well, you know, there's pockets of rain clouds in between where I'm going, so yeah, this happened. But usually after that, when it's cleared up, I would just press it down. I don't leave it on like that all the while. Alright, so over here you can see that the scooter is really quite narrow, so that I can actually like go through lane split in between the vehicles very easily. So yeah, it is actually more narrow, it's not that bulky, so it has a very sleek and slim look. After riding this scooter for a week, all I can say is that it is incredibly comfortable. That's definitely because it is a scooter, and I find that it's actually really practical in terms of moving around, especially as a photographer. I keep on carrying my cameras around, and sometimes my cameras are smaller, but I still have to carry my backpack on, and
but I can put it right below the seat. So all I can say is practical in terms of the storage system that is in the scooter, which I really like. For the Vespa, it is okay. It's a bit narrow, so I can put my camera stuff on this, but when it comes to helmets, well, I cannot fit in, but at least in this bike, you still can fit in. And overall, the windshield, the auto windshield, which is damn awesome, especially when it comes to rainy weathers. And of course, in Singapore, we cannot really ride fast, but in terms of pickup, I feel that the pickup is fairly quite similar to the GTS 300. And I was actually riding with my wife with a Vespa GTS 300. The Zontes can actually keep up with the Vespa 300 very easily. Then I also feel that it is actually a good delivery bike as well. In terms of comfortability and power, yeah, but in terms of the fuel efficiency, I tried the Eco mode and I tried the Sports mode. So basically the Eco mode and Sports mode, the fuel efficiency difference is actually quite, how to say, it's not that big of a difference. So for the fuel efficiency, for the Sports mode, is 3.9 liter per 100 km, while for the Eco mode is 4.1 liter per 100 km. So basically that's the difference. It is running on a 12 liter tank. I find it okay for my usage, but it depends on how you use. So when it comes to fuel efficiency, it really really depends on how much you throttle, how much you whack the bike. It is far different from it is definitely far different from the Zontes 155G that I actually reviewed last year. That one is like 21 liter for 150cc tank. Well, this is a 12 liter for 310cc. So yeah, you cannot compare like this. So but overall, I find that this is a very good daily bike. Okay, that is definitely a very good daily bike. So I hope you like this video, and if there's any questions that you want to ask in regarding this bike, just feel free to comment below and I'll try to answer the best I can. When it comes to the price, oh yeah, I nearly missed out the price. For the price, right, is 9,900 before COE. Okay, the reason why I actually say before COE, because our COE now currently is super high. At this point of the video is 10,000. So yeah, 10,000 COE, just imagine. Yeah, hopefully it will actually lower down. Hopefully lah, hopefully, really. But now it's very high. So it based on the time of the video is 19,900, yeah, 19,900 because of the COE. So for international friends out there, COE is our Singapore certificate of entitlement. So without it, we are unable to ride our bike. So own a bike as in fact. So yeah, that's for you guys out there. So I hope you enjoyed this video and I see you in my next video.